For today's video, I've stumbled across something really quite special, and I found a plugin for Illustrator that can do so many different things to text and also objects. Now we are going to discover its uses and its function, but also we have to ask the question, is it actually worth it? Now it's great being able to show people how a design looks, but even more impressive if they can actually experience it too, and this leads to them understanding how it's going to behave. And so learn more about Framer later in today's video and how to show off your designs. We are going to get to the price later, as well as a possible free version. But let's first learn about the plugin, because you don't want to miss how to actually use it. So once you've downloaded the plugin, you have to actually copy the relevant folder, and then paste it into Adobe Illustrator's plugin folder found here. So once you start up Illustrator, there are two main locations this plugin can be found. Firstly, there is the window panel, and this is where you're going to find most of the action. But there are also things to be found in the effects menu too. We're going to look at these later, but first let's head over to the window menu. Now I'm not going to show you every single thing in this menu today because it's going to take too long. But let's firstly take a look at the 3D path because that's got quite a lot to offer. So I have this neat little panel that shows up, and each panel with this plugin does have some guidance found in the bottom left corner here. However, I did find that clicking this and reading the manual sometimes did crash Illustrator, so that is something to be aware of. We can also collapse the panel for better organization, and that's always nice to have. So the first action for this plugin allows you to distort things in a three-dimensional way in Adobe Illustrator. Now my text hasn't been outlined, by the way, but watch as I transform the shape of a torus with my text. And the torus is just that classic donut shape, by the way. With the live update box checked, we can edit things in real time, which is something pretty powerful. We can even distort the perspective of the design like so. Also notice the rotate tool found here. Now this helps us maneuver the design in real time, and look how neat that is. But yeah, remember that I did say the text hasn't been outlined. And so we should be able to edit the lettering itself, right? Yes, we certainly can, and it's a great upshot found across this entire plugin. So as you can see, I'm actually removing parts of my text, and then I'm going to add some others as well. Everything is happening in real time. Let's take a quick look at some other 3D options, such as the cylinder here. Much like with the torus we saw earlier, we can edit things in real time and make a great use of that rotate tool. The twist option is pretty cool too, and I am still amazed that we can actually continue to make alterations to the wording of our designs at any moment throughout the process. There are many options in this 3D live menu. We are going to be here for most of the day if I look at all of these, so instead, let's move on to the next section in today's video. In this menu, again, we have many options within options. But let's take a look at the reflection option here. Now these plugins often work with both text and also objects, and I can make great use of the reflection on text. So this is going to allow me to make reflections vertically and also horizontally, and yes, you can head back in and change your text at any stage. The live tail creates some nice designs in relation to the settings you choose and you work with inside the panel. I really cannot get enough of these live edits. What do you guys think about them? Now if you click the expand function, you will turn every single part of your design into an actual vector shape. For this next one is something I've wanted for the longest time, and if you are aware of the pattern brushes in Illustrator, this might appeal to you as well. Now we can take a design or an object, and we can make a border with a square or in a rectangular fashion. We do have access to the adjustment settings in the panel, and so obviously we can tailor the design to our needs. Like I said, there are a lot of different options in this window alone, and you can have a nice time, you know, looking around and experimenting for yourself. The last two I'm quickly going to show, and those are the live generation and also the live circle. Both will offer some interesting and some quick edits in Adobe Illustrator. So let's take a look at the second half of today's plugin, and you can find that under the effects menu. Now we do have four different options, and I have tried the fractal function, but it was quite buggy, so I'm just gonna leave it alone for today's video. The lens option offers up some really neat distortions to text and also to shapes. The fish eye is kind of bulged within the mask area, and we can move it around in a live function if you check the preview box. So that's the fisheye. The next one is essentially something that acts like a magnifying glass. And yes, it does work in real time as well. The final one twists and twirls the contents within the masked area. And this might be something that you want to experiment with or even use for your design. The final two options are warp and wave effects. You can find some of these built into Illustrator already, but we don't actually have this nice accessible panel unless we have this plugin. So how much is this plugin going to set you back? Now you can get a free trial for 15 days or 30 Illustrator restarts, but the price to actually purchase the Filter It 5 plugin when recording this video is $129. And remember, I'm not sponsored by Filter It 5. But is it worth it? Now money is relative, and to some people $130 might be something like 1 month's wages, and to other people that might just be pocket change. And I personally can afford it, but I feel it is a tiny bit expensive. I did notice a few issues and bugs, so if they were cleaned up and addressed, maybe I would consider the price fair, I'm not quite sure. Now interactive prototyping is the best way to communicate your app and your website designs. The sponsor of today's video, Framer, is a no-code, free-to-use tool making it easy for anyone to become a prototyper. So you can import your existing work and quickly swap out your static elements for pre-built interactive components. This includes things like sliders that actually do slide and inputs that can be filled, as well as buttons that can actually be clicked. Building out a full user flow is super simple as well. You can just link screens, buttons, and menu items, and pretty soon you will have a prototype that clearly communicates your vision to whoever you want to show it to. Now sign up for free or get 20% off any paid plan by visiting framer.com/satorigraphics. That link is down in the description box below, so do give it a try if you are a web or app developer. But yeah, if you want to watch another video with free plugins in Illustrator, click the video on screen. And until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.